Welcome to the Vue File Upload tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to add an image preview of files uploaded using the Syncfusion Vue File Upload component. I will explain how to preview image files using image elements, as well as how to create custom upload and remove buttons for handling images. First, I open my existing Vue application where I have added a file upload component with a custom drop area and an anchor element with the necessary alignment class and styles. Also, I have configured the asynchronous settings and restricted uploads to only the JPG and PNG image types. To learn how to integrate the file upload component into a Vue application, check out the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application using the command npm run dev. The file upload component renders with the defined custom drop area, alignment, and style. I can click the browse hyperlink and upload files. It uploads the files to the server, and I can delete them using the delete button. Also, I can drag and drop the files to the custom drop area to upload the files. Next, I will show you how to add an image element and show the image previews for each uploaded image. To create a list of preview images, I need to create UL and LI elements for the number of files when selection is performed in the uploader. So, to get the selected file list in the uploader component, bind the selected event with a method name. In the script tag, add the method's property and implement the method on file selected, which receives a parameter. Within it, I need to create a UL element to create an unordered list. So I use the document's getElementByClassName method and use the uploaderPreview class name to access the uploader component. Use the first uploader component and append the UL element as a child. Use the j2BaseCreateElement method to create a UL element with a class name eUploadFiles. I will use this class to query and assign the list elements for each uploaded image. To access the createElement method, I import the createElement from the j2Base. Also, I import the isNull or undefined method to validate elements. In the onFileSelected method, add a condition to check whether the UL element exists. If it doesn't exist, I need to create one. This will ensure that no duplicate UL element will be created when uploading is performed multiple times. I use the selected event parameters files data property and iterate over the collection to get each file. Then I call the form's select data method, passing the file as an argument, where I will create the list of preview images using the LI elements. Implement the form's selected data method. Within it, use the createElement method to create an LI element. Set the class name as the uploadFileList and the attribute dataFileName to the file parameters name property. Create a variable and use the createElement method to create an image element and set its class name to uploadImage. Create a span element to wrap the image element. Append the image element to the wrapper and append the wrapper to the list element. Next, I need to set the preview image to the image element. To do so, create a file reader variable. Using the reader variable, bind the onLoad event with an inline arrow function, call the listElementsQuerySelector method, pass the imageElements class name, and set its src property with a reader's result. The file reader's onLoad event will be triggered when the file reading operation starts. I call the reader's readAsDataURL method and pass the argument file's raw file property. It is best to set up event handlers before starting asynchronous operations to ensure they are ready to handle events as they occur. I append the LI element to the UL element so that I can get the list of preview images. In the onFileSelected method, I cancel the selected event so that I can avoid the default selected operation. In the style tag, use the uploader class and the UL element class and set the height and width to the elements so that an image of any size will be previewed with these size settings. Set the margin property to 10 pixels. For the upload file list class, set the display property to inline block and width to 165 pixels to align the preview images. Now I browse and select two image files. You can see two preview images with the provided styles. Next, let me add the respective file names and their sizes to the preview images. In the form selected data method, use the list element variable and append a division element as a child. Set its class name as filename and its inner HTML to the file's name property. Similarly, append a division element to display the file size. Set the class name to file size and in the inner HTML property, set the file size value. The uploader instances bytes to size method converts bytes to kilobytes or megabytes for easier understanding of the size value. In the style tag, I add the styles for the file name and file size classes. This will create padding, overflow, width, and white space handling for the file name, and for the file size class, it sets the padding property. I browse two image files. You can see the file names and their sizes in binary prefix with a provided alignment. Now I will show you how to add file upload and remove features to the preview images. First, I will add the elements for uploading and removing and then implement their actions. So, in the form select data method, create a variable and assign a new span element with the ID icon upload and a class name. Append the upload button element to the list element. Similarly, create a span element for the remove button. Here, the ID and class names are provided respectively. In the style tag, I add the needed styles. I have added a new uploader icon font. I have set this new icon to the upload span element with custom size and position. For the delete and remove icons, I have set the position background color, border radius, font size, and position. To make the icons invisible by default, I have set the visibility property to hidden, and when hovering over the preview image, it is set to visible. Here, I have customized the background, border, and color for all the icons when hovering over them. I have set the icon content using Unicode characters in the upload span element. I select two images. And while hovering over the preview image, you can see the upload and remove icons. Hover over the icons, and you can see the hover effect on them. Next, I will add click functionalities to these elements so that they act like buttons and perform the upload and remove operations. In the form select data method, for the upload button, add a click event listener by passing a method name. Whenever I click this upload icon, the upload file method will be executed. I implement the upload file method, which accepts an event parameter. Within this, I need to upload the file details to the server. Since I am manually uploading the files, I need to maintain the file element details and the file details. So, to store the file elements in the data function, I define a property, file elements, and assign an empty array. I will use this to store all the LI elements that hold the preview images so that I can easily remove them from the DOM when the file is removed. I define the files details property to store the details about the files. These details will be uploaded to the server. In the onFile selected method, set the file's details property with an array. Concatenate the file details default array and the selected events file data. This enables me to store the file details even when uploading is performed multiple times. In the form select data method, use the file elements property and push the list element. Now, in the upload file method, define a variable to store the file index and assign the index value of file elements by using the current target's parent element property. Now, use the uploader object's upload method to upload the file as an array using the file details property and the file index value. I pass true for the second argument since this is a custom file list. Once the file uploads successfully, I need to indicate it in the user interface. So, in the uploader component, bind the success event with a method name. Implement the method onSuccess, which accepts an event parameter. This event parameter contains the details about the uploaded file. Get the list element by querying the document with the data file name equal to the event's file name. Check whether the event operation is upload and then remove the event listener for the upload element so that I can avoid listening since the upload is completed successfully. Query the list element's file name class and set its color to medium green so that I can understand the upload is successful. Query the remove icon and replace the class name from file remove button to file delete button so that I can see a different icon to delete the uploaded file from the server. I select two images. Clicking the upload button uploads the file, and once the upload is done, the file name changes to a green color, indicating the upload is successful. The remove button is changed to a delete button for the uploaded file alone. The other file's remove button remains the same. Next, let me implement the remove functionalities. In the form select data method for the remove button, add a click event listener by passing a method name. I implement the remove file method which accepts an event parameter. Within this, I need to delete the file from the server when the file is deleted after uploading and remove it from the client side when the remove action is performed. To do so, define a variable to store the file index and assign the index value of file elements by using the current target's parent element property. Get the file information using the file's details collection and the file index value. Add an if condition to check if the file info status code is equal to 2. If it is, then the file is already uploaded successfully, so we can remove it from the uploader component. So, use the uploader object and call the remove method by passing the file info. This will remove the file from the server. Call the uploader object's clear all method to clear all the file-related data within the component object. If the file info status code is either 1 or 0, then it means that the remove operation was performed after the file was selected. In this scenario, it is still in a ready-to-upload state or a file type is not allowed state. So I manually remove the file details from the file's details collection using the splice method and the file index value. Also, I remove the element from the file elements collection too. To remove the element from the DOM, I use the detach method from the EJ2 base package and pass the event's current target parent element. This will remove the LI element from the DOM. In the EJ2 data import statement, import the detach method. Use the uploader object's clear all method to remove all the file-related data within the component object. You can notice these remove operations were not performed when the file was uploaded and then deleted. So, to perform this, in the onSuccess method, add an else if condition and check whether the operation is remove. Remove the list item from the file's details collection using the list object that I already created. Do the same for file element collection. Detach the list item from the DOM. I browse and select two images. Now I can remove a file which removes the elements from the DOM alone. Also, I can upload a file and then I can delete it. This will delete the file from server and also removes the related elements from the DOM. Let me wrap up this video. I have shown you how to preview files uploaded using the Syncfusion Vue File Upload component. I have also shown you how to create custom upload and remove buttons for handling images. You can download the example used in this video from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link where you can check if you're eligible for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Vue suite. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.